Olympism is based on a philosophy of life that combines sport, education, and culture. The values of excellence, respect, and friendship bind people around the planet. It's a story that comes from a long time ago, and I, Ricardo Prado, an Olympic medalist, will tell it here. It's the Draw My Life Olympic Movement. The games began around 776 BC in Olympia, Greece. At the beginning, they were related to rituals for the religious worship of Zeus, and due to their sacred character, even wars came to a halt during the competitions. This was known as the Olympic Truce. Over 12 centuries, the competition ensued always every 4 years, until they were halted during the rule of Theodosius I. In the year 393 AD, the Roman Emperor forbade the games, considering them a pagan ritual. Much later, French Baron Pierre de Coubertin, a great enthusiast of education through sports, created the Olympic Movement, a philosophy that puts sport at the service of humanity. On June 23, 1894, Coubertin created the International Olympic Committee. By the way, that is why this date is celebrated worldwide as Olympic Day. 2 years later, in 1896, the first edition of the Olympic Games of the modern era was held in Athens, Greece. In 1914, Baron de Coubertin created the most important symbol of the Olympic Games. The five rings in blue, yellow, black, green, and red colors, together on a white background, represented the union of the continents and forming the Olympic flag. The colors were chosen to ensure that all countries in the world had at least one of the colors of their national flags represented. Besides the rings, other symbols reflect the Olympic ideals. The motto Situs, Altius, Fortius, which in Latin means faster, higher, stronger, contains the essence of overcoming limits. The torch is the link between the game's ancient and modern era. The sacred fire is considered a purifying element. After being lit in Olympia, the flame passes through a relay that announces the games and conveys a message of peace and friendship. Other important symbols are the Olympic Oath, which has taken place ever since the Games in Antwerp in 1920, and the Anthem, which was created in Greece for the first edition of the Games and was adopted by the IOC in 1958. It is played in all the ceremonies when the Olympic flag is hoisted. Some 120 years have already passed since this new stage in the history of the Games began, and they have grown in sporting and cultural importance. Today, we have both Summer and Winter Games, and this is in addition to the first Youth Olympic Games that took place in 2010 in Singapore. 2 years later came the first Winter edition of the Youth Olympics, held in Innsbruck, Austria. Adding all of this up, there already have been 50 editions. The first, in Athens, were disputed by only about 240 athletes from 14 countries and 9 sports. In London, 2012, there were approximately 10,500 competitors, 204 nations, and 26 sports. The next Winter Games will be held in 2014 in Sochi, Russia. And in 2016, the Olympic Games will be in South America for the first time, in Brazil, in Rio de Janeiro. It will be a big party with memorable celebrations, and everyone's invited to draw yet another page of this history.